Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah wahda, wa salatu wa salamu ala man la nabiya ba'da, wa ala alihi wa ashabihi al-mufin ahda, amma ba'd. Fa'a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillah ar-rahman ar-rahim. Inna Allah ya'murukum an tu'addu al-amanati ila ahliha, wa idha hakamtum bayna al-nasi an tahkumu bil-adl. Inna Allah ni'ma ya'idhukum bihi, inna Allah kana sami'an basira. Sadaqallahu al-Aliyyul Azim. Respected teachers, honorable chairman, distinguished delegates and dignitaries, humbleized and authorized, my dear fellow friends, brothers and sisters, with me in this blissful moment of joy. Here, I would like to share some words about the topic, Umar radiallahu anhu, the symbol of justice. Firstly, I would like to express my deep heart praises to Allah the Almighty, who blessed me with this memorable opportunity, alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. Dears, as you all know, Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu was an astonishing personality in the history by his broad-mindedness, leadership, unswerving faith and pity, sincerity, and many other personality determining factors. His name is often paired with justice, truth, bravery, and courage. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has indicated in his hadith, يَقْتَدُوا بِالَّذَيْنِ مِنْ بَعْدِ أَبِي بَكْرٍ وَعُمَرٍ. Follow two of my companions after me. They are Abu Bakr and Umar. In another context, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has declared, إِنَّ اللَّهَ جَعَلَ الْحَقَّ عَلَى لِسَانِ عُمَرٍ. Allah has inserted the truth in the words of Umar. Yes, such was his character. Such was his obligation with his citizens. Such was his intervention in his administrative responsibilities. When he was in power for 10 years, he never surrendered to injustice. Never, not a yet of injustice. As I mentioned before, his name is widely exemplified in social justice, not only just in Arabian history or historians, but also in the books written by renowned Western historians. If you leap over the pages of history, we can find out that he has laid the foundation stone for many public welfare projects, which could later characterize as revolutionary movement. He has set up well-maintained and systematic concept of Baitul Mal and child security elements, meaning every child gets benefits every week to keep them afloat. Brothers, Umar bin Khattab was a kind of responsible ruler in the world. He tried hard for absolute prosperity and welfare of his own people. He would secretly roam around the streets of Medina in the dark night to evaluate the life standard of his citizens and help the poor and undoubted. He was unbiased and unprejudiced in the delivery of the rules among his citizens. Let me recall an image. Once, when Abdul Rahman, the son of Umar bin Khattab, was in Egypt, happened to drink alcohol, which is forbidden or haram, and the one who drank it should be punished according to the prevailing rules in public. But Amr ibn As, who was in charge of Egypt, concealed the event and punished him in private, thinking that publicizing would tarnish the image of Umar. When Umar got to know this, he summoned his son to Medina, and he himself punished him in public. According to Umar, all the punishment was not the intended punishment, as it was carried in private, whereas the punishment should be made in public. Brothers, to understand how just and fair Umar bin Khattab was, the remark made by Hormuzan on Umar is sufficient. When Hormuzan, the administrator of Khuzestan, brought to Umar as detainee, he saw Umar sleeping in the floor of Masjid, without any palms and fatherless ruins. Then he made a historical statement. A statement that should shake the heart of everyone who has a glory. Hakamta fa'adarta fa'aminta fa'nimta. You impart justice in the rule, so you are fearless. You don't need any special bodyguard. You don't need any added security. You can sleep in peace and tranquility. How beautiful and meaningful are those words. My friends, this was the justice and rule of Umar bin Khattab. He never put his citizen under the despicable state of injustice, partial of peace. He's the powerful epitome for contemporary leaders who try to treat every rights and privileges of citizens. We have a lot to ponder over his eventful life, but I don't want to drag out my words. May Allah bless us all. Ameen. And here I conclude. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.